Hey guys, Wandering Beast here, and I want to talk about probably the most commented, questioned, PM'd thing I get about the Adventure Bus are the lights. They're extremely non-standard. It's not something you normally see. Now, I specifically created this look to be a statement piece and continue when I build the Adventure Bus. I have a specific look in mind. These headlights help me get that look. Now, if you guys remember back to some of my earlier videos with the International Scout, I did an HID retrofit. And if you don't know, retrofitting is anytime you're going to take a newer technology, generally a projector lens, and put it into a non-typical housing. So back in the day, it used to be halogen, and then eventually you got into HID. Fast forward now, a bit of a rant, but you've got LEDs are so prevalent on the market. People are putting all these LED bulbs in their stock housing, and that light just cannot get focused and shaped properly on the road. So you end up with light everywhere, which is annoying. It's not legal, it's not safe, and it's not even the best way of doing it. So retrofitting for me was a way to get better performance, an updated look. Now I'm stuck with a 2001 because I wanted this motor. I wanted the 7.3 power stroke. So I didn't want to go to a newer truck. So because of that, I wanted to update the lighting. I wanted to get modern lighting with modern performance. And let's talk about it a little bit. All right, so in front of you is the E350 headlight. This is an aftermarket headlight, which had a little bit better front lens and was just a little bit more easier to modify. Now, the first thing you're going to see is this daylight running halo, if you will, is out of a 2013 to 15 Ford 150 Raptor. And it does not fit perfectly. It's a very tight fit, but this is actually from Diode Dynamics. And what it allows me to do is to have that very, you know, updated look. It has a safety factor to it, as well as I've turned it into my turn signal. So you've got that very modern performance as well as a safety feature where that turns into a turn signal. And I absolutely love it. Now, the other thing I've come to realize is this is actually bright enough. It projects a bit in front of the vehicle. When I turn my blinker on, I noticeably have less light output on that side of the vehicle. They are a tremendous and terrific product, and I highly recommend it. If you're looking into it, look at Diode Dynamics. Hey guys, I'm currently just doing a quick little test. We're out here in the desert, playing with my lights a little bit. If I just put on my sort of halo eyes, these are my Diode Dynamics, I have discovered that I can actually see really well.
All right, now through the brush scrapes and the dirt and everything else, you can see in there, this is a Morimoto 4.0. It does have a bezel on it, and I've chosen to black out everything inside. And so I'm running currently a, I believe it's the Night Laser by Osram. And then I also have some 50 watt Morimoto bulbs that I will be putting in here to test out, but I really like the sort of warmer color and the great output color that the Osrams give me.
All right guys, I will be putting in some sort of build shots here. This is not a how-to by any means. I recommend you either seek out information on how to retrofit your own and why, and I went into a little bit. I hate to make this a huge rant video, but please do not just put high-powered bulbs in your stock housings unless you've done your homework and know that they can handle it. Unless you have a good cutoff beam. With these Morimoto 4.0s, I get a very wide spread. I get a beautiful cutoff pattern, and I get, with the 50-watt ballast, I get a lot of output. Now, the color is extremely natural with the Osram Night Lasers in there because I don't really like the higher Kelvin. And again, if this is all gibberish to you, please go do your research. This is the color spectrum from that kind of more goldy daylight color to those really blue, almost purplish lights that you see out there. Do your homework, do your research, and find out how you can do this yourself. It isn't difficult. It is a learning curve. This is only the second retrofit I've ever done. I certainly would do it differently if I were to do it again. However, there are companies out there that will do them for you. Go look up Diode Dynamics. Go look up the Retrofit Source. And go look up, there's a company on the East Coast called Lighting Works or Light Works. I'll put their websites or their company names down below. There's also a gentleman in California, if you've got a van specifically, he also does, I believe, Dodges and a few other vehicles, but he will retrofit and send you already pre-set up to put into your van, and it's called Van Optics, Vantage Optics. And again, I'll put his website down there. He's probably number one person that I send people to when they ask me about these lights. Now again, I did this on purpose. I wanted a statement look. I wanted higher technology and just better performance while on the road, and I'm hopefully achieving that. Now the Diodynamics SS3s we'll get to in a later review. They're the fog lamps that you see there. We're going to get those fully installed when we build out this front bumper. But I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope this helps anyone. And I want to see more of you guys kind of bite the bullet. You know, find that creativity. Go outside the box. Don't have a truck that looks like everybody else's. And that's kind of what I was going for. Obviously, the Adventure Bus is extremely non-typical. My name is Cody. This has been Wandering Beast. And we'll see you down the road.
Thanks for all the love and support. You guys are amazing. Please like, share, and subscribe. Follow the adventure on social media, and we'll see you on the road.